Hey everybody, Harry here to talk about the FBI quote-unquote search of Biden's vacation residence in Rehoboth Beach. I use quote-unquote because, as I've said before, we really need a new word for search, because search connotes what happened in Mar-a-Lago and what the Constitution discusses in terms of legal requirements. You have to develop evidence of probable cause, that evidence of a crime is going to be found in the place that you search. You have to go to a neutral magistrate. That magistrate has to approve a warrant. Then you burst in with the suspect or the person who's being searched, not knowing about it, in your big FBI emblazoned jackets, and ransack the place, etc. That's a search. What happened today with Biden, as has happened throughout, is more a what? Well, for most importantly, it's voluntary. Biden knows about it. And I don't know if it was at Biden's invitation, as the previous one was, but it's a completely obvious routine law enforcement move under the circumstances. Robert Hur, the special counsel, now has taken the reins of the Biden investigation. And of course, if you can do it, you want to search everywhere, top to bottom, to make sure there are no other documents there. That's something, in a sense, that Biden has to welcome and takes the heat off him for what the media continues to call the drip, drip, drip of rolling production. Now it's the FBI that's doing it. If something is not found, it's the FBI that didn't find it. Now, not to deny that the entire, at least PR aspect of this, has been terribly bungled by the White House, and what could have been one story with no real suggestion of criminal conduct has turned into, if my count is accurate, five. They have now the FBI has gone in, and you're going to hear these breathless accounts. Perhaps you heard them yesterday, of escalation in the Biden search matter, and more analogies or comparisons or even contrast. It doesn't much matter. To the Trump situation, the whole thing shouldn't even be said in the same breath, but it will continue to be. It is just so night and day, and the dominant fact here remains: there's just no evidence at all that Biden has done anything, I mean anything, that is worthy of a criminal investigation. Some documents have turned up at different spots in his house and residence, in his house and office. That's not good. Shouldn't happen. But to all accounts, it's something that happens a lot, including to Vice President Pence. Asterisk here, by the way, Merrick Garland has a tricky decision in front of him. The absolute equal thing to do, if he appointed a special counsel for Biden, would be to do one for Mike Pence, because it's the same conduct. But, you know, this path lies madness. Does he cut his losses and take the disparate treatment of Biden on and those accusations? Or does he keep going down a road of criminal investigation where none is warranted? Repeat, none is warranted. So that's really the main thing today. Of course, now that Hur is around, if Biden would say yes, they would go and search. And of course, by the way, I saw some people questioning, why haven't they searched Trump's other properties in New York and Westminster, et cetera? Because Trump hasn't consented to them. If he had, they'd have been all over it. But Trump is saying you're going to have to develop probable cause of a crime. If they had the same requirement for Biden, they wouldn't have searched it either. But Biden is being cooperative. So another round for him of, you know, ugly quasi-criminal suspicion and the like, drowning out, by the way, good economic news, a very important, interesting showdown with Kevin McCarthy about the debt ceiling, really important things. And you'll continue to have poll numbers suggesting, oh, yeah, Biden should be prosecuted too, 30 or 40%. And really, they just couldn't. It is, in fact, night and day. All right, turning to Robert Hur, who's now taken the reins. DOJ policy is that if someone's come under public suspicion for whatever reason, the department needs to either clear them with haste or bring charges. This actually, you may remember, figured in the Mueller investigation. One of the reasons why he wouldn't charge, Mueller decided you can't charge Trump or that the policy would be followed, is that if you did charge him or say he committed a crime, but then you couldn't bring charges because of DOJ policy, the accusation would be hovering out there. Trump wouldn't have a chance to defend. That would be unfair. Likewise, these intimations of some kind of criminal activity parallel to Trump's are A, bogus, and B, unfair. Hur's job is to make quick work of them. I fear he won't. I fear he'll, take a lot of time. And you can imagine it might not be easy for him in the sense that his ultimate investigative move here is an interview with Biden. And probably you do all you can to set that up first, forage for all the former Biden VP staffers from 2016 who might have packed this up. What happens if in the course of this, he stumbles onto a tax violation or who the hell knows what by one of these Biden staffers? Does he go off on a frolicking detour? He shouldn't. His eye should be on the ball. That ball should be charging or clearing. And really, it's got to be clearing unless there's some lightning bolt that would completely come out of the blue. Clearing Biden and quickly. We'll see if he does it. I fear he won't. For now, Biden has Robert Hur as a kind of barnacle on his neck. Can't do anything about it, but at least can be divested of responsibility, and the stories that plagued him and perhaps will continue, but they are really all the more off now of drip, 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 rolling production White House hasn't handled. White House has now said, have at it, DOJ. And if there are any problems, things that haven't come up, it should be quite clearly on the watch of DOJ and not President Biden. All right, so there you have it. We are off and running on this special counsel investigation, which, as I suggested, it's a misadventure because there's no basis for saying a criminal investigation is warranted. Still, more to come on this from Hur. We'll see where he goes next and how long he takes. Until then, talk to you later.
Thanks for tuning in. If you enjoyed this video and other Talking Feds content, please take a second to like and subscribe. Talk to you later.